Yesterday, December 7th, 1941, a date which will live in infamy. The United States of America was suddenly and deliberately attacked by naval and air forces of the Empire of Japan.
Hello everyone, welcome back down to the dry dock. I'm Brian, your host, and today is the 80th anniversary of the attack on Pearl Harbor in 1941, December 7th. I wanted to take a few minutes to honor those who sacrificed so gallantly during that attack and all those that followed after the attack. This ship, the USS Arizona, though not being the only ship sunk, has become the iconic symbol of our fight for freedom at the start of World War II. 1,177 sailors were killed and entombed in the Arizona. At 7:55 a.m., December 7th, 1941, the first bombs dropped. That is 11:55 Central Time, which is in about 45 minutes. 2,355 servicemen and women were killed, 1,100 wounded, 68 civilians killed, 35 wounded. So this did not just affect the military, it affected the entire state of Hawaii, the entire country and world. I still, to this day, every time I watch anything to do with Pearl Harbor and honoring those who sacrificed for freedom, I get a tear in my eye. Because the importance of what happened on that day and the days following embody what our country is all about. We stand for freedom. We stand for personal choice. We stand for being united without any form of discord. This great experiment of the United States of America is a republic. A democratic republic. And these people and many others before them and after them fought to keep this great experiment going. If we take nothing else away from the sacrifices they made and our servicemen and women and make today, if you don't study the past, learn from it, honor it, you're doomed to repeat it. There are 77 approximate survivors still alive today from that fateful day, all of them over the age of 94. We are not going to have these heroes for very much longer. We need to honor them every chance we get, along with all our servicemen and women who serve to protect us and freedom throughout the world. There was a project started 6 years ago to identify those who were unidentified from the USS Oklahoma on that day, and they were interred in the Punch Bowl National Cemetery in Hawaii. 6 years ago, they started up a program to try to identify as many as they can. That project has come to an end. They identified 400 of those sailors. That's incredible. Welcome home, boys. Job well done. That group of men and women will, in my mind, will never be repeated. And it's sad. They were brutally, horrifically attacked and thrust into a situation that forced levels of courage and sacrifice never before seen. Their honor, dignity, and service paved the way for us to have the country that we have. And yet, today, that is missing. As a country, we aren't unified like they were back then. Even back then, they were divided on whether to get involved in the war or not. Unfortunately, it took a war of that magnitude to bring this country together. If we learn nothing else from that event, is we are better, stronger, and more forgiving when we are united than we are when we are divided. I pray to God that we learn the lessons from this day and never have to go through this again. For all of you out there who served, have served with distinction and honor to fight for our freedom, in the memory of those who came before you, I thank you. I honor you, and I appreciate your hard work for us. Today, at 3:00 Central Time, the ceremony out in Honolulu will be broadcast. I'm going to watch. If you're young and you don't know a lot about Pearl Harbor, I've never been there, I would like to, I encourage you to watch this ceremony. It's inspiring, it's tear-jerking, and it embodies the United States of America. I cannot put into words what a day like today means emotionally. We went through it in 9/11. I pray we don't have to go through it again. And with that, I bid you all adieu. Have a great day. May God bless the United States.